Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to show you how to paint baseboards when you have hardwood floors or any type of a hard surface type floor, whether it's laminate, vinyl planks, or whatever it is, other than carpet. In my opinion, this is the fastest and the cleanest way of painting baseboards and shoe molding. When you don't have fancy equipment like airless sprayers and things like that, if you want to paint something in your house by yourself, this video is definitely for you. All right, let's get to it. All right, so this is what we're going to need. We're going to need a putty knife, like a really, really long putty knife, which I already used for a little bit. A handy bucket with some paint in it, medium stiffness brush. What I prefer for acrylic paint, Sherwin-Williams product called Solo Satin. Like the product. It's not the high-end product, this is not the superior quality, but it's a decent quality product. But this video is not about the paint, it's all about the techniques. So let's get to the process. All right, so what we wanna do here is we wanna slide our blade right into the gap in between the floor and our shoe mold in this case. In most of the cases, you're gonna have a tiny bit of a gap between your baseboard or shoe mold and the floor. Don't worry, you're not gonna scratch the floor. Nothing's gonna happen with it. And then you start painting it, trying to not put too much paint on the blade. And as you move on, you just simply slide the putty knife out, and this is how I do it. You kind of twist it. This way, the paint film that you have down here kind of breaks, and then you don't have any paint on the floor. Super simple, super easy. And then you just move ahead and paint next section. And as you move along, what you want to do here is obviously you want to use a nice technique, and you don't want to put too much paint on. You don't want to apply it too thin. But what is important, and I would mention here, is that you would want to start somewhere here and then kind of feather your edge and drop it somewhere here. You paint another section and you do the same thing here. And this way you move forward without any paint on the floor, without making a mess. And as you guys can see, there's absolutely nothing on the floor. Super clean. And as your putty knife gets really, really dirty and there's a lot of paint on it, you just simply get your rag and clean it. And you do it every several feet as you move along. And another quick thing that I wanted to share with you guys is the pad that I'm using. Obviously, when I'm crawling around the room all day long, it gets super hard on my knees, right? And also I play goalie, so I do want to take care of my knees, so this is what I came up with. I find that the density of this particular pad that I believe is made for, you know, kids, for like a home style playground zone, and I just glued three of them together, super nice and easy, and it works really, really nice. So I hope this helps. All right, that's it for this video. I hope you guys find this helpful, and until the next one, take care.